U.S., Director of Human and Cultural Marketing Specialist from the Ohio State University Staff Center. We want to share with you today some opportunities we have to learn about producing local foods here in Ohio. So stay tuned. First of all, one of the most recent upcoming events that we have is the Southwest Ohio Specialty Crop Conference, and that's actually coming up at the end of this week on February the 6th, and it will be held at the Oasis Conference Center, which is in Loveland, Ohio, just outside of Cincinnati. And it's a great opportunity for you to learn about how to grow various types of crops, how to manage those crops. You can actually get some credits for your fertilizer certification as well if needed. And there will be a number of breakout sessions that you can attend at that conference and learn about a variety of different specialty crops.
Quick question. Mm-hmm. When you say specialty crops, what are they talking about?
So, specialty crops are the horticultural crops that don't really fall into the traditional, I think, of agriculture like corn, soybeans, and wheat. Specialty crops are things like potatoes and peppers and berries and hops and wine grapes. Those kinds of things that really are marketed to specialty type markets that consumers for food consumption. So, they require a lot more management typically. This is really for anybody that does business and increases a variety of breakout sessions from the Southwest Ohio Specialty Crop Conference. They have three times that are open. And they have things like how to manage the crop through fertilizer applications, how to pull a soil test properly, and interpret the results of that soil test so that we can ensure that you're getting nutrients on that the crop needs, that's enough waste to clean, and fire time for the things. We're also even going to be hearing about some of the liability issues that can come about when you're working with all things with food. It's a great way to learn from a variety of different types of work, all in one location, and it can help take connections with information in place to connect to your
family. So that's February the 6th. It is right around the corner.
That is indeed. So if you'd like more information about that particular conference, you can either register for that conference. And if you have until February the 4th, to register, there is a $50 registration fee, which includes the materials and a meal. And you can find that information at, I don't know if we can put up the flyer that has the link to that event information on it, but you can read the website. It's cdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcdcd
even in our interest of companies that individuals go to be constant members of the sector, that's a very competition of a lot of different programs from the market, but there
So in March we have quite a few opportunities for you to see some opportunities to learn more about your operation and tasks and how to grow. And really that's the focus of our team, the agricultural marketing team. We really would like for producers to have the resources they need to grow their operations effectively, market and customers so that ultimately they can be quite easily successful with their operations. So coming up on March the 10th, which is a Saturday, we hear about the Ohio State University South Center in Tyson. We will be having our second annual Average Tourism Ready conference. And we're going to be talking about local food and local fun. And what could be more enticing than food and fun altogether. So we're excited about that. We held this conference for the first time last year, and it was very well received. We had over 75 people in attendance. So we're also looking forward to a successful conference this year as well. There's a variety of different topics that we'll be talking about. Again, viability, how do you think split out the tourism operations? If you are an agritourism operation, really that means is that you own a farm and you would like to general public onto your farm for your financial benefit, whether that's the particular type of operation or whether it's some of the agritourism. As I mentioned, one of the things we talked about last year at the conference was the new agritourism law that was passed here in Chicago. So as an agritourism operator, you can get rid of that law and the benefits the requirements of that law for your operation. We'll also have a few sessions at this conference where we hear from other producers that are out there doing this successfully. And one of the things that we do anytime we have workshops is producers like to hear from their peers and like to hear what's worked for them. So we'll have these in-house sessions as well, where you'll hear from your peers and help to get ideas about how to grow your operation.
It can be $25 for one individual, a crowd of two, it would be 40.
Right.
And then it's my understanding for all Farm Bureau members, it would be a $20 check.
$5
a check. So, really, for an all day affair, that is really good.
It is a great deal, and we're able to do that not only because we are working with a biotech bureau and a high-tech bureau, such as this conference hall. We're also working with the Ohio State University Resource and Ag Law Program, as well as Brad Morgan LLP, which is a law firm here in Ohio that helps work with agritourism and farm-based businesses. So it's through their support that we're able to offer this every week.
So that's March 5th.
March the 10th, yes, and you need to register that for that by March the 2nd. We're expecting a big crowd, so the sooner you register, I think the sooner you can get that conference, the better. And then you can contact Crystal Barber and you get to email and have a brief question about your address. There is a screen so you can get registered for this conference, just as a tourism region conference.
This question before we continue, because you have some really exciting programs. I'm going to take a short break. We're with Christy Walsh. Christy is the direct food and agricultural marketing specialist. And we're talking about our candidates. We'll be right back in a few moments. So welcome back. We're talking with Christy Walsh. She's a direct food and agricultural marketing specialist. We were talking about some of the events lot of different business programs. So what's coming up with the most places?
So this is the next level conference. So actually, this conference is put on by Brad Rutherford, who's our board control specialist here at the Ohio State University of South Centers. And this is the 6th or 6th year for the Ohio Pop Conference. And it's a great conference, always very well attended. As you may know, hops is a growing crop in Ohio. We used to grow many hops here in Ohio 4 years ago. Most of that left the state, and it's now coming back. And if my numbers are correct, I think we currently have about 200 acres of hop production here in Ohio. So if you're interested in producing hops, and this is definitely the conference for you, and that is coming up, and it will be held here on the Ohio State University South Center in Princeton. March the 23rd and the 24th, which is a Friday and Saturday, down the street there. The goal is to register to March the 10th. I will tell you that this conference has sold out every year, so if it's something that you want to attend, don't wait to get your registration because we are limited on space. And so you want to be sure to contact for the sale of your registration to the conference as soon as possible.
So that's for the attendees. And what about vendors?
So the other thing they have is with the Hop Conference, and there is many vendors that come to display their wares to the attendees at the conference. And so we actually have a flyer that if you are a vendor, maybe you sell the calendar, maybe you sell the post, or maybe you sell print. Any of those kinds of things that help grow and make you sell Hop's product, these vendors will come up. Have a display set up here at the conference so that you can walk around and network with those folks and help get an idea of where you can get some of the supplies that you need to successfully produce some of the product. And so that vendor form registration is on the street as well. Again, we're working on space once the 2nd is the deadline to register. So if you're a vendor that has products or services that will fit with the Hops producers here in Ohio, I encourage you to take the opportunity to come and set up a display. Last year, I believe we saw 125 individuals who were registered for that conference. So it is a very well-attended conference and a great way for you to get your products and services in front of those opportunities at that conference. For the vendors, there are two charges. So if you want to set up a representative display and send the one representative that's $75 for the ticket conference, if you want to set up a display and send two attendees to the conference, that's $36 for the ticket conference and two attendees. The only other thing that I would like to come to is they have a Ohio Hops Banquet, which is a class, the Ohio Hops Growers Guild, which is like the state association for hops producers here in Ohio, has their annual meeting. And so there is the Hops Banquet, which is Friday evening. That's a $40 fee just for the banquet. So if you're looking at coming to a conference, as a vendor or an attendee, you have the registration to attend the conference, and then there's a separate fee for attending the banquet as well. And that's usually a lot of fun.
What else do you
have? Well, the next thing that we have coming up is our market rating training. part of a network of 17 states across the country that offer this training program. And so what Market Ready goals is help producers with their different market needs. So let's say I think maybe a seller of a product directly to consumers at farmers markets. And I want to explore other market channels. Maybe I want to sell to a restaurant. Maybe I want to look at selling to wholesalers, or maybe I want to look at selling to cafeterias and institutions. The Market Ready program takes producers to those different market channels and what is required to meet the needs of those different type buyers. So a staff is going to be a different type of buyer that would be a person at a farmer's market, or they have different requirements if they're wanting to sell at an institution. So we tell producers to look at those different business functions out for those different market channels and how to try to decide, well, what markets fit best with what I currently need and how can I get what to get some of those markets.
There are a number of different food markets that sort of refers to the way to respond to any of these kind of products. Are these the kind of individuals that are thinking about food distribution?
Absolutely. So what you're describing has typically been called a farmer's market. And so that's a temporary location where producers come together, set up their tank and their displays, sell for a few hours, get away to consumers, and make sure they stay back to their farmers or other markets. And many local food producers start that way by selling direct to consumer at the farmer's market. I think we're in a situation now where the farmer's markets are too well established here in Ohio. Producers are looking to grow their businesses, and so they need additional market channels. And so, again, if they're looking to sell to a local chef, then maybe they want to sell to their local school. The requirements to do those sales are very different than the farmers market, and so it keeps them the different requirements that they need to think about how to get some of those different markets. And this is a one-day workshop. Usually we spend about 7 hours through the day, a lot of information. So we have two opportunities for that. One March the 23rd at the Ohio State University Extension Office at Claremont County, which is just out of Cincinnati. And then the other one is March the 20th at the Ohio State University Extension Franklin County Conference on the
Conference. Pretty good. What is the cost of this course?
These users are just for $25 to attend this one-day workshop, and that basically covers the, we do provide lunch to the attendees of that, and covers the materials that they have to spend. It is very nice. So it's a great return on the investment.
It really opens up the eyes of people that are
Yeah, it really is. And so it is a lot of information. I mean, it is a full day, but we get really good feedback when we look at the comments we get back from participants. For example, one producer said it's the best marketing training I've ever attended. I still have some things to do, but feel like that they now have the resources they need to continue to have a session.
So that's March 20th, Franklin County.
Yeah.
The extension office, and then March 23rd, Claremont County, which is in Cincinnati. And there you have one that I find rather interesting, the National College Cafeteria Conference, April 26th and 27th.
Yes, so that's an exciting event that's coming here to Ohio. Again, this is the National Farm to Cafeteria Conference, and the conference brings it in a completely different time. So really excited to have that in Ohio this year, and it will be held in Cincinnati. And it will be April 5th through the 27th. And really my involvement with this conference is one of the opportunities that attendees at this conference have is they do some day trip tours. So a group of those attendees will be coming here to the Ohio State University Staff Center for Python to hear about the research that we're doing to help with local growers. We're working with the right? Can't be expensive office here in the beginning. And we're going to do some strawberry work that attendees of this conference, again, if there are a lot of them, they stay cool, they can take this curriculum back and it helps keep those big requirements for it for some students. So we're excited to have them come back to the school as well. I'm sure there is, if you go to the website, farmtocafeteriaconference.org, you can find all the registration information there. I apologize, I think it's not that helpful if you have this particular time, but it is all available on the museum. And definitely the way to contact with me is through email. They take them on grade by the day and hand it out to the office. Our email address is just my last name, here, of course, as well. That number is 740-289-2071. My extension is 234, and you can, of course, put in a voicemail and I'll reach you now. It is also Chris Lars, and I'll try to get you to send us a party for you as well.
As a matter of fact, I can think of anyone to call in, but Chris and you are not there. We have a staff that we do that think that that's a true contact with the two. Well, personally, I learned that the time just is going to be really like a touch. I like all the different things that are so fast. I think it's just fantastic.
It's an exciting time. There's many, many learning opportunities coming up. And of course, we want to try to get those producers in and help them have the resources that they need so that here shortly they'll have a successful growing season for 2018, but we'll be able to get faster growth for the
Thank you.